News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the language you need to talk about the news. Hi, I'm Neil, and with me today is Sian. Hi, Sian.
Hello.
What's our story?
Today we have a very exciting story about a trip to another world.
A trip to another world? Yes. What could be more exciting than that? Let's find out a little bit more from this BBC World Service News Bulletin.
NASA has confirmed that the Juno spacecraft has entered into orbit around Jupiter after a five-year journey from Earth. Scientists burst into applause when a signal sent back across 800 million kilometres of space confirmed the spacecraft's engine had fired for 35 minutes. The $1.1 billion probe will circle Jupiter for 20 months.
OK, so a spacecraft left Earth 5 years ago and has now arrived at Jupiter, where it will stay for 20 months and record information about the planet to send back to us.
OK, well, how fascinating. You've been looking around the news websites at this story. What are the three words that keep coming up that people need to talk about this story?
OK, so three words that come up a lot are probe, orbit, and spacecraft.
Okay, so some definitions. Probe here, meaning a device for gathering information. Orbit, that's the circular path that one object takes around another in space. And spacecraft, that means a vehicle used in space. So how are these words appearing in the headlines?
Okay, so first of all, in BBC News, we have the headline, NASA probe arrives in Jupiter orbit. Okay. So we have two of our words here.
Yep.
The first one we're going to look at is probe. So here it's, as you said, it's a piece of equipment that gathers and sends back information.
Right.
But it doesn't have to be equipment. We can also use probe to talk about an investigation. So, for example, there was a probe into the company's finances.
Okay,
that's an investigation.
That's quite sort of journalistic, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
There's a kind of drama in that word,
yes,
probe,
exactly.
Meaning investigation.
Yeah.
It's also a verb, isn't it?
Yeah, so you could say, for example, the interviewer probed into his private life.
Mm-hmm.
So asked lots of difficult questions.
Yeah, and there's also an adjective connected to that to describe that type of question or questioning.
Yeah, so probing.
Right.
So you could also say the interviewer asked lots of probing questions.
Okay, well, I'm going to stop asking you probing questions.
Yes.
About the word probe, and we'll move on to orbit.
Yeah, so orbit comes up in the headline we just looked at. So NASA probe arrives in Jupiter orbit. It comes up in other headlines as well. So this one from Al Jazeera. NASA's Juno spacecraft enters Jupiter's orbit.
Right. Now, the preposition that goes with orbit, we describe something as in orbit, but if we put it into orbit, the preposition is into.
Yeah, so to go into orbit, for example.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. So, yeah, orbit here is a noun, so the path, that circular path that goes around an object.
Yeah.
Could also be a verb.
To orbit.
Yeah, so like the moon orbits the Earth.
Yes.
And as you said, go into orbit.
Yeah.
It's also an idiom.
Right.
So, for example, house prices have gone into orbit.
Does that mean they've gone into space and they're going around the...
not quite. The Earth? No, not quite. Not that sense. But it means that they've risen dramatically and suddenly.
Yeah.
So they've gone up very quickly.
Right. Okay, good. And there is also an adjective connected to this word.
So the adjective would be orbital.
Right. And that means that describes something that goes,
goes around yes.
Another object. For example, there's a motorway in the UK that goes around London. And it's called the M25. It's also known as the London Orbital.
The London Orbital, yes.
Okay, so our next word, spacecraft.
So we had spacecraft in the headline we just looked at. So NASA's Juno spacecraft enters Jupiter's orbit.
Yep.
And we also have it in this headline from LA Times. So NASA's Juno spacecraft begins orbiting Jupiter.
Right.
And we've got orbiting there again as a verb this time.
Mm-hmm. When I was a kid, I used to say spaceship.
Yeah, I still say spaceship.
We're not allowed to say spaceship anymore?
We can say spaceship, but I think spacecraft is a bit more technical and scientific, whereas maybe if you're reading a story or watching a sci-fi movie, you'll say spaceship instead.
And this word craft is quite interesting.
So craft is a vehicle that travels across water or air, through air.
All right. So planes, space, vehicles.
Exactly. Hovercraft.
Yeah.
Boats. Hovers above the water. Yeah.
Cars, trains?
No.
Right, can I say, I'd like to go for a drive in my craft this weekend. Can I say that?
That wouldn't make much sense.
No.
So, no. It's quite formal as well. Like, you wouldn't say, I'm going to Spain on an aircraft this weekend. You would just say, I'm going by plane. Whereas aircraft would be a bit more technical.
Okay. Well, let's hear a little bit more about this story from the BBC's Rebecca Morelli.
We have been to Jupiter before. We've flown past it quite a few times. The first time way back in the 70s, but this is taking us closer in than we've ever been before. And that's what makes this mission so risky, because Jupiter is an incredibly hostile world. The weather there's terrible. It has radiation streaming off it, which are kind of going to absolutely battle the onboard electronics on the spacecraft. But we don't know so many things about it. We want to actually peer beneath the clouds for the first time to see what actually lies at the planet's core.
The BBC's Rebecca Morelli there. She used the word spacecraft. And she also described the weather on Jupiter as terrible. I wonder if it's as bad as this British summer that we're having at the moment.
Surely not.
Okay, it's time now for our Facebook challenge. We've been talking about planets, and we posted this picture on our Facebook page, and we asked what it is in English. And the options were A, the Sun system, B, the solar system, or C, the planet system. What did people say?
We had lots of different responses. And in fact, Hannah Youssef said, I don't know the correct answer. Please give it to us. so we'll do that for you now. But for example, Laura Puglia says the correct answer is the solar system. And solar is an adjective which means related to the sun. And she is correct. So the answer is B, the solar system.
Yes. She is correct. Well done, everyone who got that right. So, Sian, now just time for a recap, a summary of the words we've looked at today.
So the first word was probe, which here is a device for gathering information. The second word was orbit, which is the circular path that one object takes around another. And the final one was spacecraft, which is a vehicle used in space, similar to a spaceship.
Yes. Thanks for that. And thanks for joining us. For more help with your English, go to our website at bbclearningenglish.com. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.